120. The Priceless Manuscripts. One may read year after year. One may read month after month. One may read for a lifetime, breath upon breath. But Nanak, only one thing is of value. All else is prattling in pride. Guru Nanak. One day, Shamsa Tabriz, the great Persian saint, prayed earnestly to the Lord, beseeching him, O Lord, please bring me some dear friend of yours to be my companion, to whom I may recite the tale of love, and with whom I may share the agonies of divine separation and the joys of union. The Lord, hearing this heartfelt prayer of one of his favorite sons, replied, It will be my pleasure to fulfill your prayer, my son, provided you are willing to pay the price. Shamsa Tabriz understood what the Lord meant and immediately offered him his head, thus getting rid of his ego and living in the will of the Lord. The Lord then led his devotee to Konya, the home of a celebrated professor of philosophy known there by the name of Maulvi Rum, and whom many know today as Jalaluddin Rumi. When Shamsa Tabriz saw the professor, he was seated next to a lake, pondering over some manuscripts. You appear to be very busy, O scholar, said Shamsa Tabriz. May I ask what is so seriously engaging your attention? Ah, these are priceless manuscripts, said the professor. In them are some of the deep divine mysteries, insoluble by most of our eminent scholars. I am now engaged in solving them. Sighing with weariness, he turned to his visitor, who was dressed in the coarse robes of a Sufi. These are mysteries far beyond your comprehension, my good man, he said, for they are problems that only a highly trained intellect could ever hope to understand. Shamsa Tabriz smiled, but said nothing. Instead, he stepped forward, took the manuscripts from Rumi's hands, and threw them into the lake. Divine knowledge does not reside in books, my friend, he said. The Maulvi was both shocked and horrified at the loss of his beloved manuscripts, but he did not grow angry as might have been expected. What have you done, you uncouth dervish? He asked in a sad and weary voice. Whatever you may know, you would never be able to understand what a tremendous loss the world has suffered through the ruin of those rare manuscripts. Again, Shamsa Tabriz smiled. Putting his hands in the water, he brought out the manuscripts undamaged. Please, I beg of you, my friend, do not break your heart over such trifles as these, he told Rumi. There are mysteries beyond your comprehension. Rumi saw that not a sheet of the manuscripts was wet. As an intelligent man, he at once understood that God had sent this dervish to show him the true path. He fell at the feet of Shamsa Tabriz and begged him to accept him as his disciple. Shamsa Tabriz gave him the secret of the word. Rumi then practiced meditation and penetrated the deep spiritual mysteries. Today, his Masnavi is regarded as the Quran of the Persian language. Had it not been for the kindness of Shamsa Tabriz, writes Rumi, Maulvi Rum would never have become Molana Rum. The scholar would not have become a saint. Footnote. Molana and Maulvi both mean learned man, but Molana is associated with sainthood or realized knowledge as distinct from piety and book knowledge. End footnote.